shall find such harmony. Born of all we've known together, of Christ's love and agony. Will you let me be your servant? Let me be as Christ to you. Pray that I may have the grace to let you be my servant too. I will be there to sing you to sleep with a song,
to soothe you with tales of our journey, your fears and your doubts I will calm.
We'll live when journeys are done, forever.
Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Bernadette Catholic Church. Before we begin our service this afternoon, I invite you to please check your cell phone to make sure it is on the off or silent setting. Also, as a sign of respect for the dignity of our celebration, we ask that you do not flash if you choose to take pictures during the service. Please stand.
And the pastoral staff, Deacon Kevin and Deacon Bob, we welcome you to this wonderful celebration of the beginning of life with Benjamin and Brittany joining together. Yeah, you done good. You should see what you've done. Can you believe that? And these people are behind you for a special reason. Not to catch you, but to support you. And so we begin this true celebration of miracles in front of our eyes In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of Jesus, our Savior, the true love of God, our Father, and the joy of the Holy Spirit always be with you. My brothers and sisters, God's Holy Spirit gathers us in this joy to give witness to the love that has brought Brittany and Ben together. This love offers us an insight into the mystery of God's love. Today, also coming together, our family and friends, to give support and encouragement, and to celebrate the gift of love in marriage. Realizing the power of God's presence, let us together raise our voices as we sing God's praises. Almighty God, that these your servants, Brittany and Ben, now to be joined by the sacrament of matrimony, may grow in the faith they profess and enrich your church. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now be seated as God speaks to us through his word.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Happy the husband of a good wife, twice lengthened are his days. A worthy wife brings joy to her husband, peaceful and full is his life. A good wife is a gracious gift bestowed upon him who fears the Lord. Be he rich or poor, his heart is content, and a smile ever on his face. A gracious wife delights her husband. Her thoughtfulness puts flesh on his bones. A gift from the Lord is her governed speech, and her firm virtue surpassing worth. Choice of blessings is a modest wife, priceless her chaste person. Like the sun rising in the Lord's heavens, the beauty of a virtuous wife is the radiance of her home. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved. Heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And all over all these put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called into in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Word of the Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain. So whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. No, it's good. Are you comfy? Yeah? So, what's today? I keep forgetting. When is today? Today is the... It's solemnity of something. No, what's the day? What's the January the what?
Second.
Oh, okay, yeah, right, yeah. And about a year ago, what happened? Can you tell me? We got engaged right here. What day?
Christmas Eve.
It was a fast year, wasn't it? I told you. Didn't I tell you? Hold on to your seats. It's going to be fast. Okay, so that was Christmas, December the 24th. Okay. And then what happened? No, after Christmas. I blessed your engagement. And then what happened? COVID-19. So how many people here survived COVID-19? Raise your hand. All but 10. This is sad. I don't know about you. But note, and the reason why I bring that up is because when y'all were excited, I mean, your faces glowed as very much as they are now. You all were so excited. And you didn't have a clue what lay before you, did you? So why did you go through with all this? I mean, with all the hassle, I mean, your COVID testing and all that stuff, why did you do it? Yes. She told you to. Okay, well. Excuse me, do you mind? When you heard the words, "wait till we get home," what does that mean to you? But you stuck it out. There were so many obstacles that were in front of you. so many challenges in front of you, and yet you took each other. We all did. I'll be really honest with you. It was a challenge, and I will bet my last $2 that it was a challenge for all of us, and yet you're here. You're here. How did you get here? And don't tell me car in the Gulf Freeway. Don't tell me that. But you ask yourself, how did we get here? And even with all the challenges, somehow the hand of God was on you. You were blessed. The Spirit lay upon you to give you strength and courage. And you said, we're here. In a few moments, for the first time in the first day in your life, you are going to make a commitment to each other. And you are going to proclaim from your heart your agreement to the vows that you will make. And those vows say to you and to all of us, we're going to be together for life. Richer for poor, which probably you are now. Good times and a bad. What's that third one I always keep forgetting? Sickness and in health. You could say it, sure. Until death do us part. It is a gift. And what happens now is that you make that commitment even in the midst of challenges, in the midst of suffering, in the midst of hardships, in the midst of celebrations, in the midst of surprises, in the midst of accomplishments, you're going to live those vows because the hand of God is upon you. Now, excuse me for a minute. May I talk to them, please? Yeah, please. Yeah. So the hand of God is upon us, right? And we're going to help them be able to live those vows, right? Your parents know that, what it means. And we all know what that means. But to make it really happen, again, we open ourselves to the hand of God who is with us, who is with us. Pandemics will come. In different forms or another, sometimes it's called chicken pox, you know, or mumps, or colic, you know. But we'll be able to look at that and to see where God's face is, even in the midst of those things that challenge us. I'm going to say this, how blessed we are to be here this afternoon to witness that together, to witness the beginning, and for a lot of us to witness when you celebrate your 70th anniversary. So if we are ready, we will now witness Ben and Brittany make their life commitment together. Dearly beloved, I encourage all of you to stand and witness with me. You have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and this community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. For Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you together. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. So in the presence of this community, all those who stand with you and who love you, I ask you from your heart, do you do windows? Do you do windows? Okay. Ben and Brittany, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
Yes.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into this marriage, please now join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. Ben, do you take Brittany for your lawful wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part?
I do.
Brittany, do you take Ben for your lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death should you part? May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. For we know that what God joins together, no one must ever divide. Amen. Bless, O Lord, these rings which we bless in your name, so that those who wear them may remain entirely faithful to each other, abide in peace and in your will, live always in mutual charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Brittany, take this ring as a sign of my love and my fidelity. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Ben, take this ring as a sign of my love and my fidelity. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Trusting in God's love and goodness, let us now offer our prayers for this couple and for those in the whole world.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church throughout the world, may our faith in the love God has for us be expressed in our love for one another. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world, may all lands that suffer violence and injustice find peace and reconciliation. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all gathered in prayer today, including those unable to celebrate in person, may our support of Brittany and Ben remind them of God's love and support. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those preparing for the sacrament of marriage, may they grow in wisdom and grace and see their vocation to married life as a sign of God's love. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Ben and Brittany, who celebrate the sacrament of marriage today, may they experience the love of God, the support of family and friends, and blessings through their children. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who are sick and who have died, especially John Wilkins Roach, Claire Warner Roach, Clarence Lester Hackney Sr., Sarah Jane Pedigo Hackney, Raven George Satchel Ben Jr., Florence Bell Satchel Ben, and Lois Wright Bilski. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, Jesus taught us to ask, to seek, and to knock. Confidence that you will now look upon our many needs. Consider our trusting faith, and in your great love, grant these requests, which we present to you through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable by God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of this sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth and baptism gives increase to the church through Jesus. Through him, with all the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end, together we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of the death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop George, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, with one voice we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that these servants now married in Christ may mercifully be poured out the blessings of this grace and make of one heart in love by the sacrament of the body and the blood that those he has joined by a holy covenant. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginning of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they may no longer be two, but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man and the companionship they had had in the beginning is endowed with a one blessing, not forfeited by original sin or washed away by the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of your love and peace abide in your daughter, Brittany, And let her always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband entrust his heart to her so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in the flesh. May they be blameless in all they do and with the strength that comes from the gospel. May they bear witness to Christ before all, and may they bless with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children. Grant that, reaching at last together the fullness years for which they hope, that they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. We pray this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Safely let us share with each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
At this time, we invite everyone to come up. For those who are Catholic and are able to receive Holy Communion, we will offer the body of Christ in the side aisles. If you're not Catholic or not able to receive communion, please come up to receive a special blessing. Just cross your hands over your heart like this to receive a special blessing.
Deus ibi est. Jesus, love has brought us here today.
Let us stand in prayer. By the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, accompany with your loving favor what in your providence you have instituted so as to make of one heart in love those you have already joined in this holy union. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Our Blessed Mother has a place in your lives, right? Huh? Okay. And so you want to give her honor, don't you? Okay. I invite Brittany and Ben to bring special flowers to the Blessed Mother. It's a sign of your affection.
Ave, Maria.
Ben and Brittany, please bow your heads as we pray over you. May God, the all-powerful Father, give you his joy and bless you in your children, and the church says,
Amen.
May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad. And the church says,
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth his love into your hearts, as the church says,
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, descend upon you, remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us show our love and congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Benjamin James Hackney.